To cut up, but hello everyone on this fine, probably you're watching this November. I lost the stuff to do. It's still October, so hello everyone, it's me, Hippocool85. Today we're gonna be reviewing the FNAF movie. It was cool. This video will have spoilers, so I recommend you skip the video until you see it. It's on Peacock in theaters too. Well, at least, like, if you're watching this in like 2 years or something. Yeah, it's out right now if you're watching this recent, but yeah. There's a promise I was gonna wear the Freddy costume in the FNAF movie. I did. It was an event by Pugos Pizzeria. I didn't get any photos, but I wore that little Freddy vest, but yeah, I couldn't make the whole costume, but then a day later I did. That was definitely perfect. But I did wear it. I did have photos. If not, I'll just post them on my community. I don't care about my face, but still, if I can, I will. But yeah, that's pretty cool. And well, I think recently got announced the FNAF movie is getting a sequel, so maybe I'll wear it again. Actually take video. Or still fit me? Probably not. But yeah, the movie is pretty good towards fans. Critics don't like video games movies. Example with Mario and Sonic. Those were good movies. Critics like this a lot. Like, I guess they just like blood and gore. Because they rated other good movies. Not good, I don't know. Horror movies. With, like, you know what I just stated. Rated R movies. And this movie, I felt like this got a little bit more PG-13. Which I think Hollywood's making PG-13 more, like you can do more stuff now. Which, geez, I don't think we should really do that. But, hey, there's a lot of stuff. It's a cool movie. 8 years, would I say it's worth it? Sure. Like, 2015, I was a little child, like 5, but still. Now we're just getting this film. Wow, many delays. I can understand, we just want to be perfect. I think it's perfect of the budget. I understand the budget wasn't that mainstream. It was a lot, but it wasn't, like, a lot of sets or, like, a lot of, animatronics for sure. That's probably why, but, yeah. And now we're gonna go on spoilers, so I recommend you click off this video and then watch it again. And then, of course, what everyone says, come back, or you can just not, I don't know. And then spoilers, okay, 3, 2, 1, go. Like the premise, which Mike dreams about kids, his brother Garrett going missing. Which every night, and then he goes in the pizzeria, and then the kids show up, and then they like do some freaky stuff, and then they know who Mike know who took them. It was a rabbit, what I guess they shown, and then the song they use, like talking in your sleep, which is kind of ironic to these segments, which is, I like the lyrics, if you can find them, probably don't want to get risk, but they sound like the segments, like, I'm like, I know what you're sleeping about, or something. Not, that's not the lyrics, but something like that. But That's like the major cool thing, I guess. They always used like 3-4 times. They didn't have the March of the Torderos, I think that's what you call it, which is just in Freddy's music box, like that, you know. But, only one time, which, spoilers, the credits, they had the Living Tombstone song, the FNAF one, the Five Nights at Freddy's, which has, they'll probably have it, like, on their Twitter, they had, like, they're at Universal Horror Nights, they were performing the Living Tombstone team, I guess, and CG5, I guess, and other FNAF, only like one more, but I'm really glad they did put that in. Maybe next movie will be the, thing, and well, yeah. This story has more lore, definitely. Not more lore. Different lore, probably. Maybe Afton's, kids didn't exist. Like, Michael Schmidt. Steve Raglan, sorry. Did look at him weird at that one part when he needed a job because he beat up someone's dad. Which was from the drama of his brother getting kidnapped, which I couldn't understand, but it's just kind of goofy if you think about it. Like, he was there because he beat up someone's dad, which, like, he beat up someone. And, well, yeah, that's where he kind of got the job, at least. But, like, there's kind of enough William Afton. I guess. People said there's like, we needed more, but kind of what segment parts can you put him through besides the first start and the beginning, ending? Which is Frank Lockseed. We only saw a bit, but there's no blood really. Like in the minigame. And I would like to mention, cupcakes only used for evil, like. He bites Carl's face, which is the guy that breaks in and gets eaten by Cupcake, which, wow, that's like one of the PG-13 things I'm surprised about. His face? At first, I thought his face was just bitten off, but no, it's just a bunch of cuts. But still, jeez, that's still like, I can see his chin was just like, that doesn't look like. Yes, that was horrifying. They had Sparky, which is like they had a restaurant name. Like, I wish they could have had like, I know, maybe another character, or like at least keep like Sparky, restaurant or the animatronic. Maybe change the restaurant name because of Sparky. Yeah. I guess. Wonder if they got permission to use them. Probably not, but Sparky isn't the original name. It's a dog actual name. At least I think, but I just can't say it. It's just a little reference. They had a Shadow Freddy next, and someone thought it was Mr. Hippo. If it was, I would have been freaking out like, oh my god, but sadly, no. Maybe in the next movie, or in the sixth one, probably do a trilogy by Scott. Hopefully reference to him. Please, Scott, if you're watching this, I liked your movie. I thought it was okay movie for, like, this little game series. But, yeah. And there's, like, And then that lawyer guy, Doug, he's the best character. Everyone likes him. I think he's getting a U2s, but yeah, hopefully. And then that Vanessa guard, I feel like she didn't have enough writing. Like, I don't know if this is just me or she's like kind of looked like no when she was acting, which yeah, it was kind of, yeah, we didn't have the red eyes that much, so whoever doesn't like it, yeah, which I know why they added the red eyes if you want to go no guys, okay, because evil robot people, not people, machines have red eyes when they go evil, like Terminator, Michael Myers, just kidding, you know, basically like that. I don't think Terminator went evil, it's just, you know, but still, he's still evil. Yeah. But, yeah. And well, do you think this movie was small enough? Yeah, I feel like it was small enough for just one. It was enough. Like, yeah, Corey was in there. The creepy balloon boy guy was pretty cool. Matt Pat was in there. He's a Sparky employee. Ness, just like that. The Ness from Earthbound, and yes, that was actually a nod to him, like Ness being Sans, which I actually don't know if that's confirmed. He is in Smash Brothers, so yeah, Sans is, which I'm a big Undertale fan. I'm gonna get all the Ninjoids this year, but maybe, but yeah, that's pretty cool. That's kind of all my thoughts. I know I've been gone for a long time, a lot of subscribers lost, I mean, like, 3, but I promise I'll push out more, just kind of don't have the time. On Friday, there's gonna be a new video. It's a parody video of FNAF. It's made with my dad, so that's coming out. So everyone, if it blows up, which I don't think it would, probably not, but maybe, who knows? The future doesn't exist. I'm gonna make a book and have a quote on that. Yeah, I'll make a second one, but we have to wait till the video, but it's just a fun video. Nothing really, just, I hope you enjoy it, but yeah, actually, bye everyone. See you in like the next video in like a week, hopefully. On Friday, bye. Yay!